We're joined today by Miss Oksana Grishina, who is a four-time Miss Olympia in fitness, 10-time Arnold Classic champion, which, by the way, I don't think in any sport at the Arnold, I've never heard of anyone winning 10 times. Even in arm wrestling, I don't think there's anyone. That is a true domination of a sport. Incredible. I'm so happy to have you here, Oksana. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. Yes, thank you. And hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us. Oksana, I'm so excited to be part of it.
Thank you so much. Oksana, I wanted to ask you about your background a little bit, because you're only a few years older, very close in age, both of us. And I imagine growing up, you grew up at the end of the time of the USSR in Kaliningrad.
Yes, I grew up in Kaliningrad. It's very west part of Russia, and it's actually former German city. It's very small city, but so beautiful. And that's where I grew up. my family, my dad was in military for many years, and now he's retired. So, yeah, and about 14 years ago, I moved to United States to get a career. So that's where I am now.
So I've seen your dad on YouTube, actually. He was on a trip with you to visit some places in California. He has a cool mustache, right?
Yes.
You know, I used to study Russian history in undergrad, and so I was surprised when I realized you're from Kaliningrad, which used to be the capital of the Prussian Empire, the German. But apparently most people in Kaliningrad are Russian. They're not German, right?
No, actually not anymore. Yes, there's no people from Germany, but some people from Germany still visit Kaliningrad, and just, you know, to see the place where their parents or grandparents lived. Yeah, it's, we are very friendly, yes, with Germany, with Poland, with actually Lithuania, and Latvia is so close to Kaliningrad.
You spent some years in Latvia also?
I used to live in Latvia for 4 years when my father was studying in Riga. Yes, and that's actually where I start my gymnastics. That's where I start doing gymnastics. And yeah, it was wonderful, wonderful time. I remember, of course, I think I was about seven years old. Yeah.
Is gymnastics still popular in Russia? I mean, everyone in the world knows that the Russians tend to be the best in gymnastics. Is it still very popular among the youth or not as much?
Rhythmic gymnastics is very popular in Russia, and it's so competitive and selective in Russia. And that's my type of gymnastics. It's two different type of gymnastics, rhythmic and art gymnastics. So, yeah, and like I said, art gymnastics on such a high level, like nobody could get even close to Russian gymnast, and it's grow up every year. So, like in my time when I did gymnastics, there was different rules. Right now, girls doing such an incredible movements, and no one can even get close to Russian Olympics team. Yes, it's absolutely insane level. Yes,
it's one of the most beautiful sports to watch, of course, and so on.
I know. Yes, I absolutely love it, and I'm so surprised that in the United States this kind of gymnastics is not that popular. I don't know. Maybe it takes a lot of discipline, and it takes a lot of diet. You know, because girls have to be so skinny, they should not eat at all. That's what I remember. Yes, it was very strict.
Did you compete in the gymnastics or were you just training?
No, I compete in Russian championship. Of course, I have never got on Olympics, level, because in Russia, if you Russian champion, you probably will be Olympics champion, because it's, I mean, it's obviously. So, yes. And I was very good gymnast. I got higher degree in gymnastics. And that's everything I could possibly get with my genetic. Because my genetics, I always was muscular girl. And of course, I was punished by my coaches because the way I look like. So, and I couldn't understand why, you know, why some girls could eat everything they want and still be skinny. And if I would break the rules, right, and eat something, and it's just the fact on my body, on my muscles. So, yeah, I was genetically not built for art gymnastics. I was always fighting with my body, you know. But when I found fitness, I was like, oh my God, that's the sport actually I built for. And I was just so I was so happy, you know, because I was around people who look muscular. I was around people who think the same, you know. It just, I'm really happy where I am now.
When you first got into fitness, I was trying to learn more about you. Did you get into bodybuilding or like what is now physique first, and then you found the fitness competition, or did you go directly to fitness?
No, I was always in fitness. I was always fitness. It's just back then, there wasn't woman's physique. There wasn't woman's bikini. There was only woman's bodybuilding and woman's fitness. So, and then they started to do figure also. So, yeah, that's why I'm big fan of physique. I'm big fan of bodybuilding, women's bodybuilding. So that's why me and my coach, we work so hard, always working hard on my physique, because I like it, you know. I like when, I like to change, I like to challenges. And when you see your body changes, it's just so awesome, you know. So that's why we very focus on physique. And I know some people and my fans, they're like, Oksana, you do physique, right? You do woman's physique or woman's bodybuilding. I'm like, no, always fitness. Yeah, but I know I was always so focused on physique, on my physique, to look better, you know, to get result. That's what we, you know, that's our motivation. If you see result, you want to move forward, right? You don't want to stay in one place.
The question I wanted to ask is, how is fitness judged? Because is it not just the routine, which is an art form, really? It's like a mixture of gymnastics with art, performance art. But also, is it also judged on the physique also?
Yes. When I started to compete in fitness, there was more points for physique and less points for fitness routine. Round. And right now they change it, so IFBB changed the rules, and now physique is less points than performance routine, which is makes sense, right? Because fitness, it's mostly about fitness, I mean fitness performance, fitness routine. So, but yeah, and that's how it is now.
It's the only competition in the Mr. Olympia that has a physical performance. Everything else is just a physique competition.
Except no. Every NPC IFBB competition has all divisions. It's women's bodybuilding. Now women's bodybuilding is back, which is so exciting. Are you here?
Yeah.
Sorry, somebody called. Now is bodybuilding back, and I forgot what we talk about. Well,
what I was going to ask you was that
everybody
else on stage, they're all not, they're just posing, but these girls are moving, right?
No, every competition has fitness. Some have fitness, some don't have fitness. Why? Because fitness is not popular right now. Because of so many divisions, bikini, figure, and wellness, women's physique, you know, and girls prefer these divisions than fitness, because fitness is very difficult sport. You know, you have to represent body plus during some acrobatic routine. It's extremely difficult. It's almost impossible. That's actually why I love this sport, you know. But some athletes can't realize that if you have background, if you have passion, that's way better to do fitness, because you have 2 minutes on stage and people will remember you. If you have something to represent, if you have great routine, people will remember you, because in figure, in bikini, they have composer round, right? But it's very short. Mm-hmm. You just make turns and that's it. So I think, and that's my message to all competitors, you know, if you have background, if you want to express yourself, if you have passion, it's good to choose fitness. Yeah, that's why you maybe not see a lot of fitness competitor on other competitions, on the bikini, figure, woman's physique, and fitness, it's just getting less popular. So that's why, you know, I want to come back and at the Olympia this year.
Oh, everyone's so excited for your comeback, of course. Everyone's so excited. But is the reason, you know, do most of the ladies in fitness have a gymnastics background, or is it just you? Do most of the top competitors in fitness have a background in gymnastics?
You know, actually not everyone. Some competitors started from scratch. Some competitors dancers. Some competitors figure skating. Some competitors did running sport. You know, it's not about specific background like gymnastics exactly. No, you can have any background. You can just be an athlete and you know, and learn some fitness movements during the fitness. I mean, that's how I did. I have never done art gymnastics, all these back flips and handstand. It's not my specific, you know. I'm rhythmic gymnast. Mm. Yeah, rhythmic, right.
I don't know. You're doing the one with that has the, like, they hang with the cross and that kind of stuff?
I do rhythmic gymnastics is when you use the ball and ribbon. It's feminine. Yes. So that's when I become fitness competitor, I start to learn all these movements, handstand and back flips and back hamstrings from scratch. So, and it is possible, you know, and I know a lot of dancers, competitors who learn these movements, and it's not necessary for judges. It's not necessary that you have lines of, you know, some back flips. We have some some movements which everyone can do. It's push-ups, it's kick, it's straddle jump. So that's a movement which is required from fitness competitors. So anyone can do it. It's just, you know, girls so get afraid when they see athletes doing some crazy stuff on stage and they got so afraid. Oh my God, I would never do this, you know. But I remember when I was young and when I found fitness in Russia, so when I was watching video of Olympia competitors competing, and I was like, oh my God, that's what I want to do. That's what I like, you know. And back then there was all performances was so gymnastics. It was only lines, you know, gymnastic lines. And anyway, it doesn't scare me. I'm like, oh my God, I have something what I would love to share with the audience. And yeah, and I decided. So it's open sport. It's open sport.
Well, it's not so open now that you're coming back. I think you're the favorite for sure for this year. Can we talk briefly about your comeback? So basically you left the stage for 2 years. And you decided to come back, surprising everyone, because you said you won't come back originally. And everyone's very excited at the sport. And I heard that you're going to be competing in Athleticon also, as well as the Olympic competition. Is that true?
Yes. Before this COVID situation. Yes, of course. I signed contract. I mean, yes, I decided to compete at the Atleticon and Olympia. Then COVID happens, and as you know, Atleticon is postponed until next year, 2021. So we'll see how it's gonna be. You know, just situation is crazy right now, and all athletes, you know, we do what we love. We train hard. And to be preparing for the show, and just we'll see what happens. Now, nothing depends on us. I mean, you know,
the Olympia will be going on for sure, right? The Olympia will still happen.
Yes. Oh, yes. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it's gonna happen. Yeah, if it's gonna be in Planet Hollywood in Las Vegas, and I spoke with promoter Dan Solomon. He 100% sure. So, and we are athletes so excited about that and very thankful that, you know, all the team, all the promoter and owner of Olympia, Jack Wood, they working so hard to make Olympia great this year. So even though this situation is so difficult.
Oksana, you live in California. I also live in California. I'm curious, how is life, you know, California, I've never been to Russia. I always wanted to go. I love reading about St. Petersburg and beautiful places in Russia, but I can't imagine a place more different than Russia as California. You know, the beaches and relaxed atmosphere. I imagine it's very different lifestyle. When you moved here, I guess in 2005 or something like that, was it
2007.
Seven, okay. Was it very different for you? What I mean to say is, how was the culture in America? What do you miss about Russia? And what do you like about America? I'm curious because I always wanted to visit Russia also. And I love Russian films.
It's different worlds. It's like absolutely different worlds. And absolutely, now I can tell you, it's absolutely different mentality. So sometimes, so when I moved to United States, of course, I couldn't speak English. I didn't learn English. I always learned German language. So, but that's why I started to learn English here. And of course, it was very difficult time for me, you know, no friends, no family, no money, no job. And, you know, it was extremely difficult time. But I'm so positive person, and it's very easy to make me happy just by small, you know, something really little, you know, makes me happy. I don't know. That's the person I am. Probably it's come from my family because we struggle a lot moving always around because my dad was military and we haven't our own place to live for a long time. So in that always keep us positive, no matter what situation could be, you know, that's probably where it's come from. But now when I learn more about America and about, you know, I start speak English, I start to understand people more, you know, their mentality, I can tell you it's like, it's absolutely different mentality. So when you want to speak in English, you have to think in English. If you think in Russian, it's just, it's make more complicated for American to understand you. You know, we are very shy people, you know, we kind of like, I don't know, secure, Russian, very secure. They afraid if, you know, when somebody asks you, how are you, right? Russian, like,
why are you asking me?
Why are you asking me? Yes, like, do you really care? And, you know, and also, when Russian feels open, they start to telling you how you're doing and everything, you know. But American, they didn't ask you really how you're doing. They just said it, you know, how are you? So that was first thing I couldn't understand. Why they asking how I am? You know, do they really? So, and a lot of small things like this, you know, it's so different, and it will be forever. You know, that's why it's different world, different mentality. But in In one thing, I was feel so comfortable because I grew up in Kaliningrad, and Kaliningrad is on Baltic Sea. There is Baltic Sea. So, and my place where I live, it's like 5 minutes walk to the sea. Wow. And when I, yes, when I found California, I'm like, oh my God, that's the place I want to live because I love the ocean. I'm a big fan of ocean. And it's just, I'm trying to always get there, you know, just to get my energy back.
There are no good beaches in LA. You have to come to Orange County to get a good beach. In LA, they're like a little dirty and stuff. Like, the beaches are not very nice. Santa Monica is not very nice either. The beach.
I know. We used to live in Orange County, and I absolutely love this place, but it's just so... It's quiet, you know? And my school, acting school, and all friends, you know, they close to Los Angeles. So, and for me, it's better to live here because there's so many things I can do, you know, and learn. And there's a lot of performers, actors. So, and I always trying to move forward and learn something. Just to improve myself in fitness as fitness performer.
Can we discuss your acting a little bit? So I think that you must have such potential as an actress because not only your looks on the stage, but also, I mean, you're incredibly gifted with movement, right? And I was thinking when I was reading more about you, I was thinking about the Netflix, because Netflix now, I don't know if you noticed this, but Netflix has a lot of foreign language TV shows. So they have Russian shows, they have a lot of, Swedish, Nordic shows. My wife is French, so we watch French shows together on Netflix. I'm wondering, have you ever thought of going after one of those American-produced Russian language good shows? And how is your approach going in with your Hollywood? Because you've been doing it for a couple of years now, right?
Yes.
It's very tough, of course, I know, yeah.
I'm a huge fan. And not just fan, I absolutely in love in acting. I love to study it. I love to watch people behavior. I don't know. I just absolutely love, maybe because I love people, you know. And it happens when I was so little, you know. I remember when we went with my mom and dad somewhere, and when I see someone and I like behavior, I can just watch it, this person forever, you know, and I can forget about mom, I can forget where I am. I'm just so in love in people behavior. I don't know why they're doing it, you know. It's just so interesting when you come to the restaurant, right, and you're sitting with your friends and just look around, and there's each couple is kind of a movie, you know. You can see how and it's real, you know. It's natural behavior. It's not acted, which, you know, I hate when people act. I like when it's natural. And yeah, I can't stop staring. People may think I'm crazy, but I just love watching people, you know. I love different behaviors. I don't know. Yes, and acting, oh my God, I don't know. I love it. I think it's very... It's very difficult profession. It's very difficult. It's so stressful, but it's also very so much fun. If you think about it as fun, not as stress, it just, yeah, I absolutely love it. I've got some great role for series. I'm not gonna tell you which series it was. But they was shooting exactly on the time where Olympia should be. And I said, please, can I come 2 days later? They said, no, that's the time you're shooting. You have to be this time. And you know how strict they are, right? It's big production, so you can't. And I said no, because, you know, like, I was just so, like, I didn't know what to do, but yeah. It was absolutely amazing audition for me, you know, and producer and director called me right after, and it was, yeah, great audition. So yeah, anyway, I'm looking, I really would love to be, you know, I really would love to be in maybe some action movie or something. It's absolutely different job. It's like I said, it's so difficult, I understand. but I love challenges. I always love challenges, and I think that's my another passion. passion.
You know what's funny? My wife and I have been watching TV a lot because of COVID. We, you know, can't go outside, so we've been watching TV, and we noticed that every time there's someone in one of these TV shows that's American but trying to do a Russian accent, the accent is so bad. It does not sound Russian at all. It sounds Mongolian or some other. It's not, you know, a Russian. So I was telling my wife, they can't find any Russian actor who can just act instead of this, you know, fake accent. So I think there must be so much potential, just even just for the accent, even without all the amazing action stuff. And but have you also applied for stunt work at all, or you're not interested in that?
Stunt work, I don't know. I love exactly... I mean, you know, stunt work is good. I mean, it's fun. I would love to try it, but I like more emotional and, you know, emotional challenges. Like when script put you in different situation, and how do you react on this, you know, and that's, I know I like this side more.
But of course. I would be curious if I didn't ask you about pole dancing, because this is, I've seen some of your pole dancing performances and they're unbelievable. I was really shocked. I don't know much about it. Living in Los Angeles, I know it's quite popular, or maybe a couple of years ago, it was quite popular with ladies to do pole dancing. Is it very popular still?
Yes, in Los Angeles, it's pole fitness grow up so fast and the level of competitors is insane. But what I realized that international competitors, their level is absolutely, it's so high. It's Russian and I think Brazil and some other countries, the pole fitness is way more popular than I think here. You know, I think, I don't know why, but last year I promote pole fitness championship at the Olympia for last 2 years, actually, when I was retired. And first year there was incredible level of competitors, and we had winner from Canada, Tara Meyer. She's absolutely beautiful competitor. And after Olympia, she got job at the Cirque du Soleil. And we were so happy about her. Yeah, it's absolutely amazing. She deserved it so well. And last year, the level competitors was like insane. So there was all girls internationally, and only two girls was from United States. Wow. And the winner was from Brazil, girl from Brazil. She actually live in United States now. But yes, absolutely impressive, absolutely amazing. And I love this sport because it's kind of like gymnastics, you know. And when you see Olympia pole championship at the Olympia, the way we produce, the way we promote, it's like a sport, more sporty. Mm-hmm. So you will forget about striptease at all. Because... yeah, there is nothing about that. It's like you may think about gymnastics or acrobatics or some circus, you know, because what they do, and it's just insane. You would never think about how many things you can do on the pole, and which related to gymnastics. It's like, I know, flips on the pole, landing on the poles, you know, it's incredible. Yes. And of course, I'd love to continue to promote pole fitness, not as competitor, as promoter. Yes, because I absolutely love these girls, and I have so much respect to the sport, because I can see how much work at stake. I've tried pole, and I know how difficult it is. It's absolutely amazing sport, and it's beautiful and artistic.
Do they have it at the Arnold yet, or just at the Olympics?
Yes, they always had it at the Arnold, and after I did my performance at the Arnold using the pole, they include pole fitness on the main stage, because they like performance. I mean, promoter like perform my performance. And I didn't do much, actually, you know. It was just small piece. And yeah, and they move for a pole championship on main stage. So it was on main stage for 2 years.
Wow.
And yes. And yeah, it was absolutely, I think this sport deserves more attention from people.
I want to ask you one final thing about Russia. I'm aware of your time. But you know, it's very interesting for me in the U.S. now, not to get too political, I just want to learn about Russian culture. In the U.S. now that, you know, we're moving more toward some kind of socialism in our government and stuff like that, I'm curious, in Russia, is there also a movement toward that or not so much? More benefits, stuff like that in the government or no? They're not so, after the USSR went down, they're not interested in that.
No, last time I spoke with my mom, with my family and my friends. No, I think that's why Russia is not on quarantine. Because if they will send people on quarantine, they have to support them, right? Because they have not job. So, but I don't think government will support them. So that's why it's open. They still have cases. But, you know, in Russia used to viruses. In Russia, people get virus, I think, maybe every season. I remember I got sick, and all people in Russia, so we used to it, you know. It was grip virus. So I don't know, that's why for Russian it wasn't a big surprise, I think, this COVID, you know, because they used to get sick all the time because of weather. So, but yeah, if we talk about politics, I don't think Russia would be shut down for a long time, because yeah.
And the Russian people, and the modern young Russian people, they like capitalism. They like the idea to make your own way in life, you know, build your own business, stuff like that.
No, it's not. It's very slowly change. It's changed slowly, very slowly. But all buildings, all businesses belong to government mostly. So there is, yeah. It's not like United States. No, absolutely different. Yeah.
About Kaliningrad, you said you live next to the beach there. Does that mean in the summertime it's a nice place to go for vacations? People have dachas there and stuff like that, or?
Yes. In Russia now we have two places where you can get perfect vacation. It's Sochi,
yeah,
and Kaliningrad. So yeah, it's great places to get vacation. And I spent my time on summer at the beach. It's so beautiful, and if you decide to go to Russia, yes, you can go to Moscow because it's place you have to see, or Saint Petersburg, but also Kaliningrad. It's kind of like European city, you know. It's very beautiful, and now it's even more beautiful. Yeah, and I'm just our government is doing incredible job. Yeah.
Okay, I have to thank you so much for your time. I'm aware of your time, but I want to thank you for being actually the first lady on my podcast. We have 25 episodes, no ladies. I don't know why. So I'm so happy you're the first one.
Wow, I'm so honored.
I'm happy. So nobody thinks I'm just trying to choose men or something. But I wish you the best of luck, although I know you don't need it at the Miss Olympia this year. Hopefully, actually, maybe I'll be there also. Maybe I can convince our mutual friend Vazgen to come as well. Maybe we can cheer you on there.
Yes, definitely. Definitely, guys. It's going to be so awesome. Please come. Please come to support.
We're expecting something like as memorable as the Joker routine and the Black Swan routine. I know it's going to be something amazing because you're so creative.
I'm working on it. Yes, it's going to be very, very interesting routine. And I absolutely love working on it. I just can't share anything on social media just to keep it secret. But yeah, it's very It's amazing. It should be awesome. I'm so excited.
Well, I'm excited to see it. By the way, your sister is also a competitor?
No, but she worked at the gym. She worked as a manager and she worked as aerobic instructor and personal coach. Yes, she did gymnastics as well when I did gymnastics. And yeah, but she's not a competitor. We don't need more than than one person who's competed. It's too much for family.
Thank you so much, Oksana. I wish you a wonderful day and I can't wait to see your performance this year.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I appreciate it. Thank you for having me.